fixing to glorify the one who set me free to change my life. And I don't really know how to put words to it, but I just want to share. I mean, for those of you that don't know, every time I get the opportunity, there's a storm. Brother Paul. What's up, brother? You guys are going to sleep in, man. There's a storm that starts happening on the inside. And I start turning these pages. I start kneeling and praying, which I'm doing anyway. But when that opportunity comes and I get the call to preach, it just becomes like a warning symbol. It comes like there's a siren going off, there's a tornado going to hit, and I have an opportunity to save some lives. Happens every time, causes butterflies, makes me freak out, causes me to skip meals. Amen? Because I don't want anything to separate me from what God has to say. Amen? I don't want Mark to get in the way of God's message. Amen? And I love each and every one of you so much. I'm not standing up here to get you to like me. I'm standing up here to get you closer to God. Amen? And God has given us a pastor that has stirred a fire deep within our soul. Amen? So I'm learning some things about the Word of God. Amen? Amen. And I got on this search for the Holy Spirit. Pastor Robert has been preaching a lot about the Holy Spirit, the need of the Holy Spirit, how we need to rely and let the Holy Spirit have a place, not only in our hearts, but in our services. And I don't know about you, but I'm so grateful for that. Amen? Amen. As he says, I don't want to come to church and go out the same way. Amen? I don't want to sit in a service where I know exactly what's going to happen due to the clock. Amen? Right. I want the clock to be taken out of church, and I want the Holy Spirit to have free reign. Amen? Yeah. Because I believe that when we do that, I believe when we come to that place, then we will definitely begin to see the evidence of that. Amen? I believe that we're already beginning to experience the evidence of that. Amen? If you're in here and you attend men's Bible study on Monday nights, raise your hand. Praise the Lord. Thank you, God. Yeah. I just want to do a short commercial. Amen? Yeah. Brother Dave's back there. You got to raise your hand. Amen? You brought us possible. But Monday nights we meet up out at George and Karen's. I almost said George and Fred's. George, if I start pontificating, just let me know. Raise your hand, brother. We all take turns. We share meals, so one of us will bring the meal, and or a couple of us will get together and bring the meal. We sit down at the table, or a couple of tables. There's like 24 guys that are showing up. Yeah. But woo. We'll sit down at a couple of tables. All glory to God, and we'll share a meal together. We'll go in, and this is the part that I really love. George and Fred give the almost the first half hour or 45 minutes to open up and share testimony, anything that's going on, anything that, you know, may be going through, because we go through things in this life, amen? Yeah. And we get a chance to share, get to know one another. Actually, last couple of weeks, we were given testimonies. And so I got a chance to give my testimony, and my son goes with us. And so he actually got a chance to give his testimony.
Yeah.
Amen? Yeah, that was humbling, amen? Nobody wants their son to stand up and say, I've had a pretty rough, difficult childhood. But the truth is the truth, amen? And I'm just thankful that Mark is in that place where he can stand up and share from his heart and very, very much experience not only the love of God, but the brothers and the brothers. Needless to say, there's some awesome food that goes down in that place, amen? And after that, we eat again and we really get full, amen? Because Jesus is the bread of life, amen? Right. But it's awesome. If you're not plugged in, just talk to one of the guys and get plugged in, because I know that there's things breaking off out of that are going to come in the near future. I'm excited about serving God, amen? Right. ladies Bible study. Amen. I've been praying. It happens every other Wednesday, right? That's when you're gone every other Wednesday. And I miss you. Praise God. But it is, you have to speak with me when you do, right? Praise the Lord. Amen. Bible study on Wednesday, every other Wednesday at Davalos household. Amen. Praise God. Yeah. God is good. Amen.
All the time.
We need to take every opportunity to raise our hands and praise Him. Amen. There is nothing else to do but grab a hold of this life, which will wear you out and tear you up. Amen. God told us to come out from among them. Amen. And I know that He has a word, so I'm going to try and get out of the way right now. And let's just bow our heads in prayer. Father, I thank You, Father, tonight for what You're doing on the inside. Father, I thank You for our shepherd who is just bringing a very clear expression of who You are and what You desire. God, I pray that we would continue to lift up His hands. God, as he fights in this war, God, that You would give him wisdom and insight. Father, tonight as we come into Your word, I just humbly bow myself before You. And I thank You for each and every one of my brothers, God. Lord, tonight I heard story after story of men that are just fighting in that battle, and they're going through it, trying to get their kids back, trying to get their wives, trying to just trust You and allow You to be the Lord. And Father, we know that vengeance is Yours, Father. And we know that the enemy seeks to steal, kill, and destroy. And we can't go and bear this war with our own hands. So Father, tonight I ask You to just bless those brothers, God, right where they're at, Father. Strengthen them in the Spirit. Let them turn to You and receive, Father, not only the bread that nourishes them, but the water that refreshes them, Father. Tonight we come just to watch You work, Father. So I pray that You would get me out of the way, Father. Use my voice and let Your word come forth clear, Lord. Let there be illustration, but Lord, let there be, Father, Your word, Father, that anoints and that guards and lightens every load that is in this room, Father. I come against every distraction in the name of Jesus. Every mindset that tries to exalt itself against the power of God, I come against it right now. I thank You, Lord, that we can come to You for deliverance, for hope, and for direction in every area, in every marriage, in every household, and in every child. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. I figured out that I am a Trinitarian. Amen. I believe in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. I just thought I had to be a vegetarian, amen? But I figured out I'm a Trinitarian and I am in love with the Holy Spirit. And I desire the Holy Spirit and I'm hungry for the Holy Spirit. And the church has put the Holy Spirit in a place it didn't belong and called it weird and crazy and it didn't belong. And we've heard pastor teaching on this. And as I began to go to God, He just kept taking me more to the Holy Spirit. And I'm saying, Lord, I can't do that. He's teaching on that. How can I get up there and teach on it? And the more that I went to it, the more that He just kept revealing the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit. And I said, okay, here we go. So I opened up and I started doing a study on the Holy Spirit. And I know that He is going to bless us tonight with that. Amen? Do you love Him?
Yes.
Amen. Turn with me to the Bible.
Yes.
The Lord. Where at in the Bible you say? 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9. Hallelujah. I'll just start there. But it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love Him. Amen? Let's stop right there on verse 9. Verse 9 alone. I don't know about you, but I'm standing before you tonight because my eyes have seen a lot of things they don't want to see. And my eyes are hungry to see things that they have not seen. My eyes are hungry for the things of the Spirit. I stand before you tonight because these ears have heard many things that they shouldn't have heard. And tonight they're hungry for hearing what I heard when I came into this place. I was so encouraged by three different men tonight, you don't even know. Not because of the circumstances they're going through, but because of the stance in the middle of their circumstances. You see, circumstances have a way of coming in and taking us places that we never intended on going. Amen? Circumstances have a way of trying to make us say things that we never intended on saying. Amen? But when you stand on the promises of God, you know that when the circumstances come, all you have to do is get down, kneel, and then wait upon God. Amen? It says, nor has entered the heart. Amen? There is a lot of things that have been put in this heart. There is a lot of things that I, as the old man, have built in this heart that I am not happy about, that I don't want to stand up here and testify about, because it is the old me, and that man is dead and gone. Amen? Amen. I stand before you tonight because there is something new going on the inside of this heart. There is new life being birthed. There is a hunger for the things of holiness and righteousness. There is a hunger on the inside of my heart for the order of God. And I know that I do not testify alone. I can see it in my sisters' and brothers' faces. I can hear it in their testimony. I can see it in the way that they walk into the room. Though the world may be coming down around them, those circumstances may be trying to wrap them up, they do not hesitate to come in and give all God all the glory that He deserves. Amen? Hallelujah. God has prepared something for me tonight. Amen? That's what that says. Break it down and read it again. Eye has not seen, nor ear has heard, nor has entered into the heart of man for those who love God. So God has prepared something for me tonight. Amen? I have to show up and get ready and experience it. Amen? Tonight, I want you to know that God has prepared something for you as well. Amen? God has prepared to take out that discouragement that the world has tried to put on you. God has prepared you to rise up and shine as a light in a dark and dying world. Amen? God has brought you to this place so that we will begin to share the word of God, which will not return void. It will begin to seep down in you, and if you'll begin to apply it, it will unravel the world from your life. Amen? This world is an ugly place right now. This world is a stinky place right now. Amen? I don't know about you, but I'm thankful I'm just passing through. Amen? But as a minister and as a Christian, my heart breaks and it puts me in tears because there's a lot of people that I love that are out there stuck in that stuff. Family members that are just going through it and don't know how to do the most simplest position in the world and let God begin to handle the situation. Amen? We have a call as the church, amen? We are the body of Christ. We have a call upon our hearts. That's why we desire to come in here, because we know there's something more. And when we come in here, we get told, amen? It's time that we take that "I've been told" and take it to the streets, amen? It's time that we stand up as lions and be bold about who we love and what we love about it, amen? So I started doing this study on the Holy Spirit, and I'm just amazed. I was telling Pastor earlier, I said, man, the Holy Spirit is from Genesis to Revelation. He's all over. And we'll talk about God, and we'll say Jesus, but you say Holy Ghost, some people will. You start talking in tongues, you'll have a gossip group in the back section. I don't know about them tongues. They're supposed to be interpreted. All of a sudden, everybody becomes doctrines in the Word of God. But if there's a gift, amen, if somebody brought you a brand new pair of shoes your size, would you just leave them in the closet? Come on! Sure, you'd be be like, where'd these come from? And you'd be like, these fit pretty good. God must have gave them 10 to check these out. We'd be supportive, right? God gives us gifts so that we can grow in the supernatural. Amen? God gives us abilities so that when we don't know what to say, there is an interpreter who will interpret for us. Amen? Because he knows that we live in a fallen generation. Amen? He knows that he's trying to get us to see that there is a road where the world says there is no road. Amen? There is a road called salvation. Amen? And it may be narrow, but I guarantee you it's not locked. Amen? It just takes a little determination. Amen? It just takes a little direction. Amen? God left us a book that will tell us exactly how to get there and exactly how to stay there. Amen? Amen? And the closer you come to God, let me tell you, the happier you become. Amen?
Amen.
I want to tell you, man. When I just say that, I must be excited. I want to tell you, man. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you something. Can I rephrase that? So I work in construction, right? And I'm working out there in the sun today. Yeah, praise God. Hallelujah. I love my job. Amen. And I'm stuck off in this building, and they're putting this little air compressor roof over in the corner of the building. And it had to be 130 degrees in that little corner. There was no wind. I'm putting up sheets, and I'm trying to prepare for tonight's service, and I'm like, just burnt. I mean, I don't think I've ever been this hot, you know? And I'm like, I was sweating at like 9 o'clock, and everybody's like, are you okay? I don't know. I'm going to make it, amen? And I, you know, I was talking to my wife, and she's like, how's your day going? I said, it's a little hot. You know, I'm trying to stay encouraged and encouraging when I talk to her, but I was like going through it. I was like, man, this is tough. This is tough. And so I was going to God, and I got in the truck at break, and I'm like, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, I have a job. I just want to run from here. I want to go and spend time with you. I want to prepare this, you know, go over this message a couple more times. And so break's over in 10 minutes, and then you've got to get back out and go into it. And it gets hotter as the day goes by, amen? And it just keeps getting hotter and hotter. And then when it got to lunchtime, it was like, just submit. I just raised my hands, and they're like, what are you doing? I said, man, I'm just praising God. I you know, it's hot, but I don't have to understand everything. I don't have to have the perfect circumstances. Amen. And it dawned on me, it reminded me of that video that we saw on Sunday where in China, they're praising God at 130 degrees in a building for 8 hours. Amen.
Amen.
And they endure serving God at the sake of losing their lives. Amen. If they get caught carrying a Bible or talking about Jesus, they will get martyred. Amen. They take that. They take that and they do that. What sacrifice do we give? Amen. What sacrifice do we give up in order to praise God? Amen. Do we shut down Facebook? Amen. Do we turn off the TV and go into the next room and spend time with God? Amen? I'm just throwing some things out there because I know that we live in some very tough days. Amen? But what God has revealed to me, because I'm so thankful, I'm almost completely broke up with TV. Amen?
Yeah.
I watch a little bit of news now and then, and it scares me every time, and then I turn it off and I pray. But we watch a movie every once in a while together, but it's hard to find a movie you can watch. But I'm almost completely broke up with TV, amen?
Yeah.
And sure, it was hard in the beginning. First, it was the cable, and it was because they raised the prices. It wasn't because I was making this godly decision. But they kept jacking the prices, and I was like, okay, I'll show you guys. I'm done. It's gone. And it was harder for the kids than it was for me. I missed a couple of shows for a while, but it's been, what, a year like now since I was, you know? And so I just stayed away from it. And what I found out in that is that I became closer to God. Amen. And I wouldn't trade that for anything. Amen. It has brought me to my knees a lot more and given me the authority to deal with some of the issues that I didn't think were issues in my life, like anger and frustration, One of the things I was able to share in Bible study is that, you know, as a Christian for 15 years, you expect somebody to get up there and say things that that everything's awesome and God is just... But the truth is that we go through things and God shows us, amen? I remember when I came to Christ, it was to give up drugs and alcohol, amen? Because I finally come to the realization that I was an addict, amen? And I wanted away from that because I had children and I wanted to raise them. I didn't want the world to raise them. Amen. And so that was my initial, give me Jesus so that I can get rid of this. Amen. And praise God, it worked. Amen. But after that, I realized I had a lot more going on than drugs and alcohol. Amen. I had pride. I had lust. I had anger. I had all these issues that we still have to work through. Amen. And God is faithful and just every single time. Amen. He's not going to leave you the same way that He found you. Amen. He loves you just the way that you are, but He's not going to leave you the way that He found you. Amen. And so what I found out is that we need the Holy Spirit to make this transformation. Amen. Pastor's been talking a lot about the Spirit. Amen. And there is a Spirit in the world and a Spirit, a Holy Spirit. Amen. That was given to us by God. And through the Word, it tells us that when we come to Christ, the old man has to die. Amen. That's baptism. Amen. We lay that old man down, never to rise again. Amen. Or so we think. Amen. Amen. So we need the Holy Spirit. We need the Word of God. We need each other. We need to be in unity. We need to show up at midweek service. We need to show up at men and women's Bible study. We need the power of God to begin to manifest on the inside of us. Amen? Because we can go to a building and raise our hands and say we love God, but if we still have a lot of the junk on the inside, how many of you know that's a hard place to be? Amen? And the Bible that we read says that those who are in Christ Jesus, amen, are a new creation. The truth will set you free, amen. And if those things are true, then we need to learn where it is that we went wrong or what it is we need to get to, amen. And so what I found is that the Holy Spirit is everything, amen. I want to throw some things out that I found on the Holy Spirit, that He is omnipotent, amen. What is that, amen? Hallelujah. Omnipotent. Let's listen. Almighty, possessing unlimited power. Amen. The Holy Spirit, amen, has unlimited power. Amen.
Amen.
And we're like, well, I don't know. I love Jesus, but I don't know about the Holy Spirit. We need to get in tune. We need to get in the book. Amen. Do a study on the Holy Spirit. I'm just telling you. Because this God that loved us so much sent His only begotten Son to die for our sins, for everything we ever did wrong. Amen? And on top of that, He didn't leave us there. He sent the Holy Spirit. Amen? Who was with Him from the beginning. He sent Him to lead us and guide us and remind us of everything that we need to do and everything we don't need to do. Amen? We've got a pilot on the inside of us, but we need to feed that heart that we got, the Word of God. We need to wash our minds with this Word every day. And the more that we do that, the bigger the voice of the Holy Spirit gets. Amen? And the more that we understand that we can come away from the brokenness of our past and we can walk into the newness that God has created for us. Amen? I totally believe it. I am convinced that we can operate in heavenly places here on earth. I believe that we can watch miracles happen. I've already seen them, but I believe that we can see even more. Amen? And I am creating a hunger, not only inside of you, but inside of me. Nothing else will be enough. Amen? I will serve God and worship God, and then signs and wonders will follow those who love Him. Amen? And if signs and wonders aren't happening, then I need to get more closer to Him. Amen? I need to get deeper into His Word. I need to take more of the world off of me. I need to get out of myself and into the Word. Amen? The Bible says, do not lean on your own understanding. Amen? We know where that got us. It got you into the wilderness of your own mind. Amen? You left confused and you came back confused. Amen? Who am I and what am I created for? You are created to worship the God who created you. Amen? You are created to serve Him. Amen? You are created to worship Him with everything that you are. And the sooner we begin to do that with boldness, the sooner we begin to feel the freedom and the authority that God has given us. Amen? We can overcome every circumstance and every trial, but we must do it by His leading in His way. Amen? That is the leading of the Holy Spirit. Almighty, all possessing unlimited power. You don't believe me? Let me share a story with you. Amen? Turn to Luke 1, 35. Hallelujah. Remember how Jesus came into the world? Son of God. Amen?
Amen?
The Spirit. The Holy Spirit. All powerful. Amen? What? The Holy Spirit is omniscient. Here's your second big word for that. Omnipotent. Almighty. Possessing all power. Omniscient. Having complete or unlimited knowledge. Amen? Back to 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 10 and 11. Hallelujah. Verse 10 says, but God has revealed them to us through His Spirit. Amen? What has God revealed? Amen? What? Back up one verse. Eye has not seen, ear nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love Him. Keep reading. But God has revealed them to us through His Spirit. In other words, God has things prepared for you and me. And He's going to reveal them through His Holy Spirit. Amen? We need the Holy Spirit. We need to understand the Holy Spirit. We need to embrace the Holy Spirit. We need to become desperate for a move of the Holy Spirit. We need to become baptized in the Holy Spirit. Amen? The Holy Spirit is going to train us on the inside. Amen? Man, some of you might be thinking right now, the inside's all messed up. You know what? I've been there. I know that. But stop listening to that old voice and listen to the voice of God. That's why the necessity of Scripture is so important and vital to our Christian walk. You cannot go to church and live off of the message of the pastor until the next Sunday when you come back. Amen? I guarantee you it happens all over America. You come in, you get excited, it actually pierces your heart. You say amen, you're like, this is it, I'm done with this, I'm going to give up that, I'm sorry honey, I'm sorry husband, I need to change. And then come Tuesday and you're like, oh, I don't know about this. Because we have gone back, amen? When we're not going forward in our relationship with God, we're already going back because the world's going forward. Amen? And we know where it's going. The Word says it. I'm not here to glorify the enemy. Amen? I'm here to empower my brothers and sisters to stand up and embrace this fight that we're going into. We've already been in this battle. We've already been casualties at one time or another. We've already lost way too many people. Amen? It's time that we rise up in the fear of the admonition of the Lord, and we go into battle. Amen? Spirit, for the Spirit searches all things. So the Spirit searches us. Amen? If the Spirit searches all things, the Spirit is searching on the inside for the things of God. Amen? Amen. You know what that tells me? I'm just going to give it to you in my translation. There is a place in my heart that the Holy Spirit needs. Amen? I haven't given it up. Amen? That's what that tells me. I need to get rid of all of my shenanigans, all my theories, all my ideas, and I need to wash it with this. Amen? Because this is what matures me. This is what the truth is. This is what sets me free. This is what matures me. This is what gives me answers when I don't have none. This will keep my marriage together. This will keep my children better. This will help me to give answers to my employer to watch my salary rise. Amen? Not that it's not about my salary, but when my salary rises, I can do all things. Amen? I can do more things for the kingdom. Amen? Yeah. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit searches our heart and He leads us. Amen? Because He wants us to love Him. Amen? We need to keep it simple. The Bible says to love Him with all of our heart and all of our mind and all of our soul. Amen? Oh, Jesus. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Okay, you ready for another big word? Let me give it to you again. I'm going to teach myself. Omnipotent, which is almighty, possessing unlimited power. Omniscient, having complete, unlimited knowledge. Omnipresent. Amen? That one's pretty good. Amen? Omnipresent. God is all places at once. What? That's hard to wrap your mind around. Amen? God's here right now. He's in China right now. He's in Israel. God's there. Amen? You can try and figure it out, and let me tell you, when you get back, I'll still be here saying God's omniscient. Praise God. He spoke it into existence. He planned the days of my life. He formed me in my mother's womb. I've read it. Amen? I know it. I believe it. You ain't convincing me that, oh, this bang happened and all of a sudden we came out. Amen? God is omnipresent. Amen? Watch. Psalms 139, verses 7. Let's see how many I can get. 7 through 11. God is present everywhere at all times. No matter where we are constantly encountered by the Holy Spirit. Amen? No matter where you are. When we confess our lives to Christ, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit comes to dwell on the inside of us. Amen? Holy Spirit's there. No matter where you are, amen? Holy Spirit's there. How much of God is in motion in your life? Amen? That will produce success. That will produce evidence of the Holy Ghost. Amen? When God is engaged in your mindset, in your coming and going, then you will begin to experience the peace that passes all understanding. Psalms 139. The Bible says, where can I go from your spirit? Where's the spirit again? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there. I don't know about you, but I can testify to being making my bed in hell. Amen. Doing things that I never should have done. God was there. Amen. God was there. And His love, He was patient for us. He was patient for us. He stood at the door of our hearts and He knocked. And the moment we said, I'm done, He came right in. Amen. Now he wants to walk and talk with us every single day. He wants us to unravel ourselves from the craziness of this world that we live in. And that can seem difficult, but when you learn to pray, when you learn to read on a daily basis, when you learn to surround yourself, amen, with believers. Look, I'm on my, what do you call that thing? My Android, amen? We talk about the power of the cell phone and Facebook and how we waste time. I do not turn that thing on unless I'm looking up scripture, amen? Unless I'm watching some preacher that's up there just trying to stir the fire up inside of me, amen? I'm constantly searching for Bible things on that internet, amen? Because there is nothing else left to search for, amen? I've been there, done that, bought the t-shirt, and I got a story to tell you if you want to hear it later on. I'll take you out for coffee, amen? But the truth is that there's nothing more powerful than the presence of God, amen? There's nothing more that we need in today's generation than the presence of God. And the Holy Spirit is willing, amen? The Bible says the Spirit is willing, but the flesh... We have allowed the flesh and our emotions to dictate what kind of God we have. And that's not giving God any credit. Amen? I heard him say it on Sunday. I blame the church. Amen? And I'm not blaming you. I'm telling you that it's time to rise up. Amen? The church has failed miserably at representing the authority and the presence of God. Amen? But no longer. Amen? We've only got one chance at this. Amen? The Bible says that tomorrow is not promised to us. Amen? The psalmist David was lamenting. He said, "Where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there. If I take wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me. If I say, surely the darkness shall fall on me, even the night shall be light about me." What does that mean? Amen? That means that no matter how dark it got, the light of the world chased the darkness out so that you could become who you were created to be. Amen? That's why you're sitting here. I don't care how dark it got, you don't have to go back to that place because the light of the world has come into your life and he's come to set you free. Amen? He's come to raise you into new life. He's come to teach you about the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen? He's come to renew your mind. He's come to give you deliverance. He's come to sanctify you. He's come so that he may be glorified. Amen? The purpose of it all is so that he is glorified. Amen? The Bible says very clearly, when the Son of Man is lifted up, I will draw all men unto you. Amen? I will draw all men. Do you want people to be saved? Do you want family members to be transformed? You don't have to take your Bible to the house and start throwing it at them. Amen? You just need to start praising God right where you are. Get the love of God on the inside of you, and the Holy Spirit will take over. Amen? You will be given instructions. Amen? You will, very clearly. Amen? Man, I got 100 places I could go, but it's 8 o'clock, man. And you guys already look tired. Hallelujah. Are you guys tired?
No.
Are you getting anything out of this?
Yes.
Say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Look to your neighbor and say, God has something prepared for you.
God has something prepared for you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, give God a shout of praise. Of the Holy Spirit is an extremely vital part of this walk as a Christian. Amen. If you are a Christian, then you should embrace the Holy Spirit. Amen. You should embrace the Holy Spirit. I just want to share, I know it's getting late, but I have some things. I got all kinds of pictures everywhere. Praise the Lord. Let me go to Romans 8 before I close. Hallelujah. Go to Romans 8. Hallelujah. start in verse 10. Romans chapter 8, verse 10. And if Christ is in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, who raised Christ from the dead, will also give life to your mortal body through His Spirit who dwells in you. Amen? Do you want to know what you were created for? Do you want to know what life's all about? Giving the Spirit authority over you. Amen? Not the flesh, not your emotions, not your past, not your bank account, not your children. Amen? Not the neighbor next door with 20-inch rims. Your purpose is to give the Holy Spirit preeminence over you so that you can go all the right places and say all the right things. Amen? The Holy Spirit is everything. Wow. I found so much on the Holy Spirit. I'm just filled, amen, with the Holy Spirit, amen? Yeah. I'm not done yet. We're going to be here for like 3 more hours. Yeah. I don't want to give you this opportunity and not allow you to write it down. I have a bunch of scriptures. If you want to, I'll give you like 1.2 seconds to get out a pencil and a piece of paper. The Holy Spirit indwells in us. We just read that, Romans 8:11. The Holy Spirit anoints us. That is the power that we need to operate in this life spiritually. Amen? That is 1 John 2:20 through 27. The Holy Spirit baptizes, Acts 2:17 through 41. The Holy Spirit guides us. That is John 16:13. The Holy Spirit empowers us. Amen? Micah 3:8. The Holy Spirit sanctifies us. That's a huge one. Sets us apart. Makes us useful for His purpose. The Holy Spirit sanctifies us. That's Romans 15 and 16. The Holy Spirit bears witness. Amen? Every one of us are to bear witness. That is also Romans 8, 16 and Hebrews 10, 15. The Holy Spirit gives joy. Amen? You ever feeling down and out? Why don't you ask the Holy Spirit what it's about? Amen? Joy unspeakable. Life abundantly. It doesn't come from Starbucks at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. You have been lied to. That coffee is burnt anyway. Amen? And it's overpriced. What goes up will come down. Amen? Not with the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit gives discernment. 1 Corinthians 2:10-16. Also John. 1 John 4:1-6. The Holy Spirit, watch this, bears fruit. That's a big one. Amen. Every one of us, that's one of them Christian crazy theologies. I want to be a fruit bearer. Can you see the love in me? Amen. Can you see joy on this face? Love, joy. Can you experience the peace when you talk to me? Amen. The peace that passes. I mean, I got it. The fruits of the Spirit. Well, that's one of the things. Everybody wants the fruits of the Spirit. Guess where they come from? The Holy Spirit. Amen. The Holy Spirit. Galatians 5:22-23. The Holy Spirit gives gifts. Amen. Oh, Jesus. I could do a series on that, amen? Walking around with our head down. Up, jump, left, take, see, take, he got this, ain't got that, ain't got them over there, they got this, they got that. Where's my gift, Jesus? What am I supposed to do? You got me cleaning the bathrooms, Jesus. Get in touch with the Holy Spirit, because if you're cleaning the bathrooms unto God, it's a gift, amen? I love being saved. Amen. Praise God. The Holy Spirit comforts us. Amen. He is the comforter. Acts 9:31. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit revives us and reveals the things of God. That's the last one. It's in Isaiah 40:13 and 1 Corinthians 2:10-13. Amen. I could go on and on and on, but I want to close tonight. Amen. And I pray that you heard something that challenged you to get closer to God. Amen. We all need Him. We need the Holy Spirit. We need the power of the Holy Spirit. God has not given us a spirit of fear. And everything that is going on in the day that we live in is creating a presence of fear in you. Amen. Your parents, your children, the world, everything that the God of this air, amen, the devil, amen, can get a hold of, he's going to use to create fear inside of you. I can't speak. My kids don't act right. I don't have enough money. I'm struggling. I have anger. I have pornography. Whatever it is, the enemy will keep you there until you do this. Surrender. Get yourself to a place where you understand that God is in full control. Then you can find the right person. Pray about it. God will give you the right person. You can get transparent, and that person will take you to hell. Amen? We have an opportunity not only to allow Him to change our lives, but the lives of those around us. Amen? Amen. I'm telling you, that's what got me saved. I didn't want my children to struggle the same way I did. Amen? I don't want my children to go down the same broken roads, the same, believing the same lies. Amen? I wanted my children to walk in the authority and the purpose of God. Amen? And that's my destination. Amen? To serve Him with everything that I am. Amen?
Amen.
Stand with me to your feet. Amen? Hallelujah. Jesus. Okay, so here it is. Here's my illustration for the night. We just talked about the power of the presence of God. Amen? I'm going to put it to work right now. If there's anybody here that has anything, amen, that they would like prayer for, I'm just going to open up the altar right now and ask Pastor to come forward and help me. Any of the elders to come forward, Brother Ronnie, George. If there's anything that you need prayer for, then that's what we're here to do, amen? Every one of us are either going through something or coming out of something, amen? We all struggle. We all need prayer. Amen? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God.